Hello everybody, I am John Was Never, and today I'll be reading Diary of a Wimpy Kid Wide Awake. I made this Wimpy Kid parody book thing, and I'm gonna read it. April, Sunday. Last night was the craziest night of my life. So much so that Rowley is still shaken up about it. So I'll start the story from the beginning. Yesterday, Rowley came over to my house for a sleepover. The original plan was to go stay at his house, but I wasn't allowed to after what happened last time. Anyways, a while after Rowley arrived, he said he brought with him these melatonin gummies to help him sleep. We soon found out that Manny had gotten into them and he was out cold almost immediately. I calmed Rowley down and told him it was alright and we could sleep whenever we wanted to. Rowley insisted that his bedtime was at 8 o'clock p.m. sharp. I told him that my bedtime is whenever I wanted it to be. Let me just say that we argued for a little bit and it got out of hand. By that, I mean that we had a full-on physical altercation. Die, mother! Soon after that, we started debating on how long we could stay awake. So we made it a competition. It's simple. Whoever falls asleep first loses. The first few hours were going great, but we started to feel a little bit drowsy. Luckily, I had a plan. I remembered Roderick had a stash of energy drinks hidden somewhere in his room. I'm the only one who knows about them since Mom and Dad won't let us have any. Roderick was asleep at that time, so he had to be really sneaky. We rummaged around in his drawer and we found a few erotic magazines. We also found some weird unicorn horn-shaped thing. Eventually, we found his stash of energy drinks. We drank maybe about 4 drinks each, and it actually started working. I was wide awake. Though, I think Rowley was a little too awake. After Rowley calmed down a bit, we both started to feel a bit tired again. I had another plan, though. If we watched a scary movie, we'd be too paranoid to go to sleep. The scary movies we have, though, aren't that scary. But Roderick had us covered again. Last year, he secretly bought an R-rated scary movie simply called Balloon Bob. Even though Rowley was scared, he pushed through and we watched the movie. At first, it wasn't that scary at all. Halfway through the movie, it showed off a really raunchy scene. I don't know if it was our insomnia, but it blew our minds. How is that possible? It can't go in there like that, can it? The movie did eventually get scary, though. Maybe a bit too scary. As in, Rowley passed out while watching it. I didn't know if that counted or not, so I shook him awake. The scary movie plan was a failure, but fortunately, Rowley had an idea this time. He said we should both go on a walk and maybe that'll keep us awake. Around that time, my memory became a little foggy. We started to get lost after around 30 minutes. Then the insomnia got so bad that we both started hallucinating.
Whoa, Greg, you look really weird.
You look pretty weird too.
There was also some weird guy we met when we were lost.
Hello, young travelers. Where might you two be heading?
I couldn't tell if the guy was a hallucination or not, so I touched him and I actually felt him. He got real mad and punched me square in the face. Me and Rowley freaked out and started running until we somehow ended up at a Corny's restaurant at 3 a.m. in the morning.
Yo, what are you two little dudes doing in here?
Rowley and I realized the whole place was completely empty. I also realized the guy working there was smoking a joint on the job. I started pressing him about it, and it soon turned into an argument. The argument was short-lived, though, because we all turned around and saw Balloon Bob himself. Ah! All three of us hid behind the counter, and we were all trying to be as quiet as possible. I was a bit confused because the Corny's guy could see Balloon Bob too. So either Balloon Bob was real, or he was smoking some crazy stuff. Before I could ask him about it, Balloon Bob found us. The Cornies worker told us he would sacrifice himself to save us. I thought he would try to fight Bob or something, but instead he started kissing the balloon. Sadly, the rest of the night was a blur for me and Rowley. We couldn't even tell which one of us fell asleep first. All we know is that we both woke up in the Cornies parking lot and our bodies were covered in peanut butter. The end.